Disgusting. Welcome back to my channel, you guys. Today we are talking about all of the styling mistakes that I used to make that I've corrected myself. A lot of mistakes I think a lot of us are still making, so let's just jump right in. To my returning subscribers, thank you so much for being here. And if you're new, welcome. I hope you stick around, hit the subscribe button, and ring my bell because we have a really good time here and I do videos like this all the time. I'm wearing Carolyn Constas because I'm feeling very summery. It's so sunny and I can't wait to get some vitamin D, but most importantly, I gotta make this video for you. So let's just start with some of the styling mistakes that I used to make that I've learned from and some that I think a lot of us are still making. So the first styling mistake I wanna talk about that I kinda added last minute is just buying items just for the brand name and the brand name only. This is a mistake that I've definitely made many times in the past. I have a couple pairs of Chanel CC earrings and they're cute and I will still wear them because I own them and I paid money for them, but they're not something I would ever buy again today. They really don't have any style or anything unique about them. Same thing goes with like a logo t-shirt. That's just a plain t-shirt, no real style to it, no nothing unique about it. Just a logo on it. That's just a styling mistake that I think it's really time for us to move on from. Definitely not against logo. I really do love some logo and some monogram pieces, but I think there has to be a little bit of style, a beautiful cut, something a little bit more unique. So these are just mistakes that I stopped making. And I think that all they do is just promote the brand. You're paying a lot of money to promote this brand. Really, they should be paying you. You're just like wearing a huge billboard of their brand across your chest. There's no real style or individuality about it. So just me personally, these are things I've completely stopped doing and I've totally changed my buying habits in this way. Number two, I want to talk about sticking to one particular style and kind of never deviating from that. Now, I want to give you an example of jeans and all the trends that have been taking place with denim lately, which is something we've talked about many times on this channel. Right now, the focus is on baggy, more relaxed jeans, and people are kind of ditching their skinny jeans. And I just want to emphasize, skinny jeans are not over. You don't need to ditch them and throw them out and sell them all. It's just that they're not the focus of fashion and trends right now, but they are very much a staple and they should remain in your wardrobe. The focus right now is on baggier jeans, and a lot of people are a little bit nervous and self-conscious to get into this trend. They feel like it's too much. They feel like they're not flattering. They feel like they look ridiculous. Now, here's the thing you got to keep in mind. When skinny jeans started trending over a decade ago, a lot of people were kind of nervous to get into skinny jeans. And a lot of people were still really attached to their boot-cut, flared, low mid-rise jeans. That was kind of the vibe back then, and we're moving out of that into skinny jeans. At the very beginning, the people rocking skinny jeans were more like the fashion-forward crowd. A lot of people were not getting down with skinny jeans because they thought they're just too 80s, too out there, too weird. They were really, really comfortable with their flared bootcut jeans. But the thing is, as this trend carried over from season to season, a lot more people started adopting this trend and kind of ditching those low-rise flares. Well, the same thing is happening right now from skinny to baggy. Again, I just want to emphasize, you don't have to ditch your skinny jeans, but you can experiment with some of these new trends that are coming out. And the good news is that you don't have to go from one extreme to the other, because with a lot of these trends, there are pieces that are kind of like in the middle. For example, with the denim, there are a lot of styles in denim that are simply just a little more relaxed. So they're very much not baggy and also not skinny. They're kind of like right there in the middle. It's kind of like a good dipping your toes in the water, starting to get comfortable with a new trend. Just try it, give it a chance, you won't regret it. Now, number three, kind of an important point to go with number two, and that is not overdoing it on the new trends that come out. Now, this is a mistake I absolutely used to make, and I've really, really changed my buying habits a lot. If there was a new trend that came in and I loved it and I loved the way it looked and it made me feel, I'd buy like 15 variations of that trend in multiple different colors. I totally stopped doing that because what happens is you go so crazy on that trend, and then even if it's hot for the next season going forward, it still is overconsumption. It's a waste of money. Usually hot trends don't last past a couple to a few seasons. They tend to die out and then all that money is wasted and you have all these pieces that are just taking up space in your closet. And I notice a lot of people do that, and I think it's actually very common in YouTube culture, just with like the constant fast fashion hauls week after week. If I am buying things from H&M, I look at H&M H&M Conscious collection, and from Zara, I look at Zara Life, and I've really become a lot more discerning in what I choose, so I pick pieces here and there, but I really don't do huge hauls anymore, multiple of the same items. It's not good for style. You're really never gonna have a chance to wear all these. You know, instead of buying like 18 different colors of boxy, oversized blazers, because that's a really hot trend right now, invest in a few key pieces of your favorite trends for the season. You'll get a lot more wear out of them, and you'll save a lot more money. Oh, this is a really important one. This is a very, very important one. I want to talk about leggings as pants. I've talked about this in a video before, and I said wearing leggings as pants is definitely a style mistake, and I still believe that to be true today, but I want to elaborate. I really need to elaborate on this, because I know what you guys are thinking. Maytel, what are you talking about? You put one foot in after the other, they got two legs, how are they not pants? There is an exception to this rule. The way that I feel about this, that I really feel like it's important to elaborate on, is that leggings are not something that you should be wearing with like business casual clothing, you know? You really should not be wearing leggings with like a button-down blouse or like a top that is meant to be tucked into your pants, because those kind of tops are made to be worn with pants. Pants with pockets, you know what I mean? Not leggings. Leggings are not pants. Leggings are for the gym or for athleisure. Now, you definitely can wear leggings as pants in an athleisure kind of way. I'm really talking about leggings in a more formal styling kind of way on an evening out or, like I said, a business casual way. Leggings can definitely be stylish if you're wearing them styled as athleisure, you know what I mean? Or if you're going to the gym in a cute leggings outfit and then you have errands to run after you hit your yoga class, of course, like, wearing leggings in that way is totally, totally appropriate. So we need to really understand the difference. When I say leggings as pants, I'm really talking about them in the way of styling them with your wardrobe. Leggings, there are so many beautiful, awesome, stylish pair of leggings that look amazing in athletic style, athleisure style, and I love when it's styled in the right way. Now, that brings me to my next point, which is kind of like a sub point of this, which is leggings with high heels, because a lot of people will think, okay, well, I'm not gonna wear leggings with a t-shirt tucked into them, but I'll wear them with maybe a long sweater, because typically that is the way we should be wearing leggings, like this, with a long sweater and like a pair of running shoes, sneakers or boots, stuff like that. But some people think that, you know, add a pair of heels and you're taking it from day to night. No, no, no. Even if a company is marketing a pair of leggings to you as going out leggings, I'm telling you, they're not. A perfect example of this is Spanx leggings. Actually, love Spanx leggings. I think they're amazing, flattering, compressing, lifting. They're actually really great leggings, and I love wearing them when I'm out and about running errands, just like living life, but I'm never gonna wear them with a pair of high heels. They don't look appropriate. If you wanna wear legging style with a pair of heels, you should be wearing a slim-fitting pant that does not have a very obvious legging fabric to it. If you go on the Spanx website, they show all their leggings with high heels. They just don't look right. Even though Spanx are not workout leggings or performance leggings, they still look very much that way. So even though they're not meant to be worn at the gym, they still do look like gym leggings. Wearing them with a pair of heels just kind of looks like you're wearing a pair of workout leggings with a pair of heels. That's why you definitely need a pair of slim-fitting black pants with different fabric and different stitching. That's what sets them apart. And that is why these types of leggings should not be worn with heels, even if you're wearing them in a more casual way with a longer top. You know what I mean? Okay. Next, I want to talk about fabric and the importance of good quality fabric. Now, a mistake that I absolutely used to make all the time is that I'd go to like H&M and I'd go to the cheapest rack with all the basic t-shirts that were like $6.99, and I'd get them in every single color because I thought, oh, this is a good basic. They're just good t-shirts for everyday wear, you know, stuff that I can get a lot of use out of. That is the furthest thing from the truth. Buying all those basics from that $6.99 rack is actually going to cost you a lot more in the long run, because although it looks really nice and perfect and crisp on the rack, as soon as you take it home, you wear it and you wash it, it gets totally out of shape from the first time you wash it really wrinkly, like unreasonably wrinkly for just like going in the washing machine, the fabric is not good quality. This is not made well. It's really not gonna last a long time in your closet. So again, just talking about that overconsumption, ultimately you're just gonna have to buy it again and again. The best thing to do is to buy something that is better quality. Look at the material at what you're buying. That does not mean you have to go spend $200 or $300 on a t-shirt. I personally would never do that. I still really value a well-priced basic, absolutely. But there is a fine line between like dirt cheap and reasonably priced, right? Even with affordable fashion brands like H&M, there are better options within the store. Like if you look in the Constas collection, might be a little bit more expensive, but if you look at the fabric, chances are it's made with better quality material and it's just overall better made. So stick with higher quality fabric and better made pieces. All right, next I wanna talk about embracing the men's section, and actually not just for women to look in the men's section, but also guys should totally open their mind to looking in the women's section. Now, this is really, really important because there are so many ways that you can spend money this way too. Not only get the trend you're looking for, but also save lots of money. Sometimes when there's a new hot trend that you really love, oftentimes those fast fashion cheap brands don't have it right away. They're not as quick as what you're seeing on the runway. I mean, they are quick, but sometimes you're not gonna find it right after you've seen it on the runway. And you know, a good example of this could be the oversized boxy blazer, which is really hot right now. Looking in the men's section is going to give you that same look without spending like a really high price point from the designer items off the runway, right? And same with oversized in general. A lot of oversized t-shirts are very trendy right now. You know, looking in the men's section, instead of spending an arm and a leg with a super trendy fashion brand, it's just overall smarter shopping. Now, I did take advantage of this a couple years ago. I was looking for a Saint Laurent belt bag and I saw it on Essence, and then I don't know what possessed me, but I looked in the men's section to see what options they had, if they had other styles that I liked. I saw the exact same waist pouch belt bag from Saint Laurent for $200 cheaper. The reason for that is because in the men's section, the one that was made for men was not selling, so it was a reduced price. It was the exact same belt bag. The only difference was that the belt was longer. That is such an easy fix. That's like $5 from your local shoe repair. So that was like one instance where I really took advantage of shopping in the men's section. So it's just like a good thing to think about, you know? Like if it's not something that you absolutely need to buy in the women's or the men's section, it's good to open your mind. A lot of good style to be had, a lot of good money to be saved. Next, I wanna talk about not getting out of your comfort zone. Not to be confused with not sticking to one style. Yes, both do have something to do with getting out of your comfort zone, but I'm really talking about like embracing the power of color. A lot of fashion forward people really don't take risks with their fashion, even though they are fashion forward. And what I mean by that is that they just don't get out of their comfort zone. I know someone personally who only wears black. She loves updating her closet every season. She loves being on trend and getting some of the latest styles of the season, but she pretty much only sticks to dark colors and black. So she's really not getting out of her comfort zone. So it's really not about being on the latest trend, but just opening your mind to new things, new colors. There's a lot of people actually in my comment section that will say to me, because I love hats, I'm such a hat person, and they'll say, oh, I love that hat on you. I wish I could wear that, but I don't look good in hats. The truth is that's really all in your mind. If you embrace some of these fashion styles and things that you love, you might be surprised that they actually really do suit you, because a lot of it is confidence. I mean, I used to feel that way too with certain sunglass styles I thought I could never wear because I have a small face. I thought I couldn't wear oversized sunnies. And those are just things that are always kind of happening in eyewear when it comes to trends. So I just kind of changed my whole perspective on fashion and trends. And I really just decided like, where would I love, you know? Not everything is always going to be perfect. But if you have confidence, I'm telling you, it absolutely is going to look good and it's going to reflect that because you're going to project that. My next point, I really want to talk about ill-fitting clothing, because this is a really, really big one. This is a mistake that so many of us make, and I've made this mistake before as well. I've heard a lot of girls say that they size up with their jeans because they don't want like muffin top hanging out. They don't want like bulging happening. But what happens with that is when you size up, for your waist. It gets really saggy and sloppy in the bum and hip area, and that's just not a good look. So all you're doing is taking away one problem and creating a new problem. It's super, super important to buy things in your right size. Really, the key is for this is honestly buying just better quality items in your correct size, because if it is a good quality piece, it's going to fit you well in your correct size. This is a very, very common mistake that a lot of us make. Like, even I still have things in my closet that I'm just like, I really need to get rid of. I don't know why I haven't yet. I'm pretty sure I still have a few things in my closet that I haven't managed to part with yet that are still not my correct size. Like, just too tight on the top, not flattering at all, super constricting. I don't know what I was thinking, why I thought that was a good look. I definitely stopped making this mistake, and I know a lot of us still do it, but this is the most common yet the absolute easiest style mistake to avoid. All right, this one might seem obvious, but it's definitely important to discuss, and not everything about this is obvious. I want to talk about bras and underwear and just the importance of wearing the right underwear with your clothing. And I'm not just focusing on size and fit. Actually, color is very, very important here. Now, I have touched on this in a video in the past, and I think a big style mistake that a lot of people assume is okay is that if you're wearing dark clothes, you can wear a light bra underneath. Most of the time, you can actually see that light bra coming out of your dark clothes. You think your clothes are dark and you won't see it, but you do, especially in bright lighting, natural lighting outside, or if you're in a setting where you're taking photos or you're on camera, which is, you know, very common these days. You're at a friend's birthday, you take a photo, this will absolutely show up. So it's really important to wear dark underwear under dark clothing. And the same with white clothing. You would think that wearing a white bra under a fitted white top is the best option. Actually, nude is much better and will show up much less than white on white. And then, of course, I just want to talk about wearing the right bras with the right tops. There are so many good bras out there today. I used to do this all the time. I'd wear spaghetti strap tank tops, and I'd have my like thick bra straps coming out. Just not a good look at all. This is so easily avoidable. There are really, really great quality strapless bras that stay in place. There are clear straps. There are so many different variations of straps that you can move and cross and shift, and different colors, clear, strapless, all of them. So this is just like a very easy style mistake to avoid. Okay, last but not least, I want to talk about hair on clothing, lint and hair, but I'm not just talking about animal hair. I'm talking about like even human hair. Now, I know, that sounds weird, but I have gone out in dark clothing and just like looked down and seen like all my blonde hairs all over my body, because we all shed hair, right? And you know, some seasons we shed more than others. I cannot stand when I see hairs all over people. Like, definitely not animal hair and lint and fuzz, but like, can we just talk about how it's kind of nasty also when it comes to human hair? Like, all your hairs all over your back or your chest, like, it's really, really not cute. Like, just, you know, when I brush my hair, I always go like this, and I always get, oh look, I even have one right now. I always just like make sure to do that every time I brush my hair, every time I get dressed, because I don't know, maybe it's just me, but hair on people, like human hair, just no, I cannot stand it. Especially if I'm at a restaurant, at a dinner table, and I'm like just looking at the hairs like hanging off your clothing, I just have like deep rooted trauma, deep anxiety of that hair, you know, slowly making its way onto your plate. I may have a little PTSD about this. I cannot tell you how many times I've had hair in my food. Disgusting. Your animal hair and lint, like keep a lint brush by your shoes when you're leaving. Like, such an easy thing. Just like give her a little one of these and a little one of these. Like so, like that. No lint, no hair, no fuzzballs on your clothing. All right, guys, that pretty much wraps up all the styling mistakes I really want to talk about here today. A lot of these mistakes I have made and corrected. A lot of us still make these mistakes, but it's really not a big deal. They're so, so easy to correct. So I really hope you got a good takeaway from today's video. I really loved making it for you, and I have so many amazing videos coming out for you. I hope you stick around, because as always, I'll be back in a couple days. I cannot wait to see you. I love you guys so, so much. So until next time, bye for now.